Kylie Jenner's appearance at the Paris Fashion Week created this buzz.
This is actually called festooning.
This could be a number of things.
Migrated under eye filler.
In the under eye area.
Very distinct how it's like poofing up.
I'm Dr. Rajani and I'm talking about under eyes today. And from the Paris Fashion Show, there was a picture taken of Kylie Jenner. Now, unfortunately, her face was tilted down like that. I'm scared to even put my face down like that. You guys are gonna see my filler below my eyes, but that's what happens. Lighting is oh so important. But in this picture, there's overhead lighting, her head was a little bit down, and you can see the under eye looked unusual. Unusual to most people, but not unusual to me. Not unusual to people in the aesthetic world. Why? Because this happens all the time. I'm gonna tell you today why. A little bit about the under eye. What are some better solutions for you? And if you're getting fillers under the eyes, three things you can do to not get this. Now, if you look at that picture, let's start there, and you see the lighting, you see a few things. You see irregularity of the contours. It's so hard to get the contours perfect with fillers because filler is a gel. So by nature, it has a line of demarcation, a starting and stopping point. And sometimes you see it like a worm, depending how it's placed. Here's the problem that compounds that. It's because the eye has thin skin, some of the thinnest skin on the body, like the lower neck and the back of the hand. So you have thin skin. You have one of the first areas to age you, me, and everyone. And then you're trying to put filler in there, which is a gel. And let me compound that with one more huge problem. The gel is called hyaluronic acid. So think about Restylane, think about Juvederm, think about Bellaterra and RHA. Those are all different ones. And they're all gonna tell you ours have this property, that property, doesn't draw water in, last 2 years, all these different things. But they're more similar than dissimilar. That's the reality. And hyaluronic acid draws water in by nature. It's why we put it on our face for skincare. So we're putting something in a very precarious place that is meant to draw water in. So if you look at the picture of her, irregularity of contour, but here's one key thing I want you to look at in that picture that we see and why injectors are going to go, oh yeah, that's filler. Look at the skin surface. And if you look at people you know or friends or people who've had filler, the skin surface has a different complexion. I'm gonna use that word complexion, as a different complexion than the surrounding skin. That can be a little lack of pores, a little bit stretched, a little discoloration. Some of you know the Tyndall effect, which is a bluish hue that we got way back in 2003 when Restylane was first FDA approved in the nasolabial folds from putting it too superficial. And when we talk about the under eye, the problem is, I said it was thin skin, there's a superficial fat pad, there's a muscle. And you're gonna say, well, Rajani, the muscle will put it deep, it'll hide everything, right? That muscle, the orbicularis oculi, is so thin when we're dissecting faces and teaching people, you can almost miss the muscle. In fact, it isn't even in some areas, it's kind of skipped. The one that closes your eye that you treat with toxin for crow's feet, well, it circles the eye, orbicularis oculi. And so even if you put it in the deep fat, or the SUF, suborbicularis oculi fat pad, on the bone, it can migrate forward and become superficial, or it loses its property. And that's why some fillers companies will tell you, well, mine won't lose the property, it'll always stay where it went, but of course it changes over time. And let me add one more huge compounding factor to it, the fact that they might say it lasts 6 months or a year, but fillers can be there, found on ultrasound easily 10 years after you put it in there. So they don't degrade like you were told. So that is the reason you get that look in that picture, and it can be seen on many celebs, on many people, and as someone myself who's had filler under the eye and have dissolved it, probably some still left. I just dissolve little bits over time. I can tell you that that's the look, and I see people in my clinic all the time, and it might be 4 or 5 years after the fact. So you can be the best injector in the world and still get that. But imagine being Kylie's injector. I think he or she got a phone call the next morning after the Paris show. I need this fixed, I need this dissolved, because we did it on our Instagram and of course had over 200,000 views and hundreds of comments, people wanting to know. Here are the things you want to consider in the under eye that you can do. Skincare is also important because it won't make it look unnatural. Just don't hammer it with actives like glycolics or retinoids. You want to have a consistent routine and don't try and get it all quote unquote fixed quickly because you use too much retinol or too much glycolics. So skincare, key, prevention, sunglasses. Moisturizer works great here. And if you want a cheap, inexpensive oil, think something like coconut oil. There's no pores to get clogged. You're not going to get acne and coconut oil, and I have recipes of under eye products. So think about that. Now, when you go to injectables, is there one better than another? Well, yes, some don't draw as much water in. And so you want, ask your injector, make sure they have a breadth of products and they can choose the best one for the under eye that in their hands and their experience doesn't draw a lot of water in. And never put biostimulators under the eye. Never put Sculptra, Lanluma, Belafil underneath the eye. Ever, ever, ever. Those are, when you get to injectables, that's it. But here's the other thing to think of for injectables. We are now in a world where you can inject all natural things under your eye. So even if you want filler, what you want to do is get PRF, platelet-rich fibrin, or Easy Gel, platelet-rich fibrin gel that we take from your own blood product, and that thickens your skin, thickens your dermis, it adds volume to those fat pads, and oftentimes you never need a filler. But for those with deeper tear troughs or that want a fuller look in the under eye, when you now add filler, you have better skin to accommodate it, and you can hide the filler. Because that's what we're trying to do under muscles of the face, is hide filler. Because no matter what, if we put filler superficially, you're going to see it. Underneath the eye, it becomes a much bigger issue because of the thinness that we talked about. So PRF can help prevent you from ever needing filler. And of course, if you are using filler, we want to hide that and prevent that discoloration. What's another natural alternative for the eyes? Think your red light, your LED. Now your LED mask or handheld red light, whatever you're using, will likely have red light and near infrared, NIR. Red light's gonna be around 630 nanometers. Your NIR, near infrared, is going to be 830 nanometers, somewhere in there. And those are great for the under eye. And here is why. You get superficial collagen stimulation and elastin. How? Because red light has been shown to improve fibroblast function. And fibroblasts produce your elastin and your collagen. And you might say, well, Rajani, I only want my collagen because that's the structure of my skin. No, you need elastin around the eye. Why? You're blinking, I don't know, 20, 30 times a minute. You're moving your eye, you're expressing with your eye, you need elastin. You have somewhere around 10 or 20% elastin and 80% collagen. So you do have way more collagen, but elastin's key, and LED helps with that. And here's the next level reason. The near infrared in that wavelength has been shown to get to the level of the bone and to stimulate the bone. And what makes the eye need under eye filler more than anything else, and even above eye filler? So in Asia, in different countries I go to, we're filling above the eye. I have videos on it. I just think it's a little maybe grotesque to show. People don't want to see that. But we often put filler above the eye for eye hollows. And I know many of you ask me about that. Yes, we do. Because the bone basically expands and melts. That's what your face does. The bone kind of melts. If you look at the picture, that's what it looks like. So you want to maintain your bone. And LEDs, the theory of that they can potentially maintain your bone, will help with your eye. So you got collagen, elastin, it helps with discoloration around the eye, and then the stimulation of the bone, all help to prevent needing fillers. If you come into my clinic, you say, Rajani, I want under eye filler. And the happy, what makes me more happy than anything is to say, you don't need filler under your eye because my day is better. My success rate is much higher, and I don't have to put a synthetic gel in your face. So the more natural we can do. Now, these things all work together. So certainly, yes, you can do fillers, you can do LED, you can do your skincare, you can do your prevention, wear your sunglasses, put your SPF, find an SPF that works around the eye. All those things are key. And let me tell you one bonus tip here that you may not be thinking of, but I love. And in fact, like 15 years ago, 18 years ago, when people came in for under eye filler, I would always do this first before I even fill their under eyes, and they loved it, and oftentimes they didn't do much more, and that is an eye peel. I even called mine the eye peel. I think it was before the iPhone. It was before the iPhone, but I had I written out. I should have had I and took it from Steve Jobs. Anyway, I had the eye peel. And what I would do is an inexpensive peel. I had compounded, a little bit of TCA, had a little bit of retinol in there. And I would do a peel around the eye, a chemical peel. Now, this is something many of you I know do at home now, but don't miss out on the benefits of an eye peel. Now, it's delicate skin. If you don't know anything about peels, you don't want to start around your eye. But for those of you that want to learn, for those that are already doing face peels, eye peels are great because they also get discoloration, stimulate collagen. That's what I said you need. Stimulate elastin, and they tighten. And between those things, a lot of people say, well, I don't need much more than that done. And imagine Kylie's young, but as you lose elasticity and you put a filler in and you get loss of the skin elasticity, filler tends to show that look that we saw in the overhead lighting because you get irregularity of contours. Now, imagine if you tightened your skin, you wouldn't have that. But that is showing collagen loss. And you're going to say, well, collagen loss, I'm 30, I don't have collagen loss. Collagen loss, I see it at 18, 19, 20, 21. Diet, food supply, glycation, sugars, sun exposure, lack of activity and exercise. Remember, exercise is one of the most important things you can do, tighten your skin, your hormones. So yes, it occurs at a young age. Now, I know everyone's interested in the under eye. You're going to want to watch this video up here on PRF under the eye. Watch me get mine, and you can see what that whole procedure is. And one down here, how you can make your own under eye cream at home, very inexpensively. Keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.